कनेक्टिव्स ऑफ स्टेटमेंट्स। सो हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द कनेक्टिव्स ऑफ स्टेटमेंट्स एंड देयर ट्रूथ टेबल्स। Of part 2, so under the part 2, so we are going to discuss about the remaining two connectives, that are third one as the implication, or in other words called the conditional, and the fourth connective, the by implication. Otherwise called the biconditional. So here we are going to discuss about these two topics under the advanced level. Here the third one, that is the implication or the conditional, if a statement uses the connective called the if then, then such a statement is said to be called as a conditional or a implication. Then the second one, which is the by implication or the by conditional, a statement which uses the condition, that is which uses the connective called the I double F or if and only F, then such a statement is said to be called as a, such a connective is said to be called as a by implication or by conditional. So here first of all let us know about the implication, the third one, which is nothing but the implication, or in other words the conditional. So here a statement which uses the connective say if then, so here when we use the connective say if then, then such a statement is said to be called as a conditional one. Then if then, then it is called the implication or conditional. Then now here the connective, in this case we are using the connective called the if then. So here it is indicated by means of the symbol called implies, and it is read as implies, whereas in this case so here if first statement P is of true, if the truth value of the first statement is of true and the second statement Q is of false, or in other words if the truth value of the second statement Q is of false, then now here it is said to be called as a true statement does not implies or cannot implies the false statement. Then P implies Q will be of the false statement. So that means a true statement cannot implies the false statement. Whereas if the first statement P is of true and the second statement, that is Q, is of false, then the implication, that is P implies Q, will be of false. That means so TF will be of F. Here the condition is of, say here TF, say here implies F. Then now here we are going to consider the truth table of the implication or the conditional. Then now here we are going to consider two statements. The first statement as P and the other statement as Q. Then now here in the third column, so here P implies Q, the conditional statement or the implication P implies Q, and whereas Q implies P in the fourth column. So here there are four columns. This is of column number 1, the column number 2, the third column, and this is the fourth column. Then now here, so there are we have assumed two statements. So when there are two statements, so here there are four possibilities. If there is only one statement, there are two possibilities. The statement may be either true or false, because we have assumed two statements. So there will be four possibilities. Those four possibilities are of. So if both may be true and both may be false, if one is true, the other may be false. If the first one is false, the second may be true. So here these are the four possibilities of the truth values of P and as well as Q. Then now P implies Q, whereas here the condition of the implication or the conditional is of TF is F. If the first statement P is of true, then the second statement Q must be of false. Then TF, the implication P implies Q, will be of false. That is, TF will be of false. We have to search for TF. So here first row is of T and T. So we need T and F. So first statement must be of, the truth value of the first statement must be of true, and the truth value of the second statement must be of false. So here in the second column, the truth value of the first statement P is of true, and the truth value of the second statement Q is of false. That is, TF will be of F, and the remaining. So here TF will be F, and the remaining will be of TF is F, and the remaining are of true. Say here, so TF is F, and the remaining will be of true, true, and the true. So similarly, when we are finding the implication, that is Q implies P, so we have to see in a reverse manner Q implies P. So here Q implies P, so we have to search T and F. So here first of all T under Q, so we are finding Q implies P. So here Q implies P, we have to see in the reverse manner. So here T and T, whereas F and T, whereas here it is T and F. So T and F will be of F here, and the remaining will be of true. By this it is clear that when we observe the 3 and 4 columns, so here the truth values of P implies Q are of TF, TF, TF and TT, whereas here the truth values of Q implies P are of TT, F and T. So they are not equal. Therefore, P implies Q is not equal to Q implies P. So from column numbers, and as well as 4, it is clear that P implies Q is not equals to Q implies P. Then now let us go for the fourth one, that is the bike implication, or in other words called the biconditional. So here, if a statement uses the connective called I double F or if and only if, then such a statement is said to be called as a bi-implication. So here a statement which uses I double F if or if and only if, then such a statement is called bi-implication, or in other words the biconditional. Then now here let us suppose the two statements. Here the biconditional or the bi-implication is symbolically, so it is I double F or if and only if, the symbolic notation is of. So here double implies, if there are of two statements, so we can write it as P double implies Q. Here in this case, if the first statement P is of true, and the second statement Q is also of true, then P double implies Q, the biconditional statement of P and Q will be of true. And even if the first statement is of false and the second statement Q is also of false, then the biconditional P double implies Q also will be of false. So for both the cases, so it will be of true. And whereas for the remaining are of false. So here it is clear that the first statement P must be of true, the truth value of the first statement must be of true, the truth value of the second statement must be of true, then only the implication. So here by implication P double implies Q will be of the true, or the truth value of the by implication will be of true. And the second case, the first statement and the second statement, if the both statements are of false, then the, or in other words, the truth values of the both statements are of false, then the truth value of the by implication also will be of true. So here, now let us consider the truth table of the by implication or the by conditional. So in this case, we are going to consider two statements. So one is of P, the other is of Q. So if we consider two statements, there are four possibilities. In case if we consider only one statement, the statement may be either true or false. There will be two possibilities for a single statement. When there are two statements, when we suppose two statements, the possibilities will be of four. Then in case when we consider three statements, then the possibilities will be of the double, that is eight. Then now here, the possibilities are of, so here both may be true and the both may be false. If one is true, that is if P is true, then the Q may be false. If the P is false, then the Q may be true. Then now here, these are the four possibilities, are the four possibilities of the two statements, that is P and as well as Q, whereas these are the truth values of the statements, that is P and as well as Q. Then now here we have to find out, so here P double implies Q, or in other words by implication of the statements P and Q. Then now here Q by implies P. Then now here, as per the condition of the biconditional, so here if both are true, then now the biconditional also will be true, or in other words, if both are false, then the biconditional also will be of true. Then we have to search for TT and as well as FF. So here in the first row, TT will be of T, and in case of FF, so FF in the last row, FF will be of also of true, and the remaining will be of false. So we can write the remaining as false and as well as false. Then in the similar manner, say a Q by implies P. So we have to see in the reverse manner. So in the reverse manner, so we have to see TT and as well as FF. So in the first row, Q is of true. The truth value of Q is true, and the truth value of P is also of true. TT is T, and here in the last row, the truth value of Q statement is of false, and the truth value of the statement P is also of false. That is FF is also of F, and the remaining will be of, because it is of F and T and T and F. So here we can write the remaining truth values as F and F, that is false and false. So when we observe the columns, that is column number 1, so let us consider this as the column number 1, and this as the column number 2, and this is the column number 3, and this is our column number 4. When we observe the column numbers 3 and as well as 4, the truth values are of TF, FT, and whereas in the fourth column it is also of TF, FT. So here from this it is clear that the columns 3 and 4 are of same, are similar, are congruent. Then now, from columns 3 and as well as 4, it is clear that P by implies Q is similar to Q by implies P, or in other words, P by implies Q is congruent to the, similar to the Q by implies P, whereas in a similar manner, whereas here P implies Q is not similar to the Q implies P. So in this manner we have proved the two conditions, that is the first one as implication and the second one as the biconditional or the by implication.